Good evening, show band, concertgoers. Welcome to Merton Hill Auditorium. My name is Bond, James Bond. Oh, excuse me. It's Todd Haig, principal of Chaffey Adult School. The Ontario Chaffey Community Show Band and the Haig family are proud to present A Salute to James Bond, highlighting 13 theme songs from films featuring the British super sleuth. Tonight's solo artists include show band musicians Kathy Soderlund, Natasha Lee, David Grasmick, Francisco Mowat, and assistant director Pat Arnold. They will be accompanied by outstanding musicians of the show band.
Hello, my name is Debbie Haig. I am an English teacher at Chaffey Adult School. It is a pleasure to be here this evening, working alongside my husband as your co-narrator. James Bond movies have spanned the course of more than six decades. The film's hero was born from the imagination of British author Ian Fleming, who was best known for his series of Bond spy novels. Fleming drew primarily from his wartime service and his career as a journalist for much of the background, detail, and depth of his stories about his super spy.
Early in the 1960s, the 007 character quickly caught the imagination of the movie-going public. Bond brought to the screen a touch of class as an agent who wore designer suits, drove expensive sports cars, and dated beautiful women, while also displaying their ruthless ability to fight arch-villains who threatened world peace. The first Bond movie, Dr. No, was released in 1962. It was immediately embraced by film buffs who were drawn to the suave and debonair super spy. They began to identify the character with the catchy James Bond theme written by Monty Norman. The unique melody would become the signature tune associated with the James Bond character. Interestingly, Dr. No was the only Bond movie that did not have a main theme song.
We begin our performance with Norman's music. It was used in Dr. No and subsequent films as a leitmotif or music phrase associated with a particular character. The theme was played in key spots and effectively tied together the storyline of Dr. No's plot to end the United States space program. Please give a nice round of applause to the Ontario Chaffey Community Show Band and director Gabe Petrocelli as they perform the James Bond theme.
Thank you.
the second Bond movie was produced in 1963. In the storyline, Spectre, a worldwide criminal organization, seeks revenge for the death of Dr. No and sends an assassin to steal a decoding device and then do away with Bond. While both were passengers aboard the Orient Express, Bond eliminates the assassin, and in the end, a female Soviet spy saves our hero by shooting a Spectre operative who was attempting to assassinate Bond. Let us give a nice round of applause to dancer Kathy Soderlund as she performs From Russia with Love. The show band will be conducted by assistant director Dave Schaffsma.
In 1964, Bond's travels take him to Switzerland and then eventually Fort Knox, Kentucky. The villain in this film is Auric Goldfinger, a gold-obsessed master thief with designs to smuggle and hoard vast quantities of gold bullion. His plan includes the bombing of Fort Knox to render worthless the gold reserves of the United States, thereby giving him the ability to control the price of gold around the world. Bond befriends Goldfinger's main confidant and personal pilot, and with her help, the plot is foiled. Sit back and enjoy the theme song from Goldfinger.
Thank you.
mission takes him to Japan in 1967, where he works undercover as a Japanese fisherman. His assignment is to thwart Spectre's mastermind villain, Ernst Blofeld, in his quest to push the United States into war with the Soviet Union. Blofeld plans to hijack an American spacecraft and use it to start World War III. Although Blofeld escapes, his headquarters, located in a dormant volcano, was destroyed by Bond and his allies. The theme song from this film is entitled, You Only Live Twice. The featured soloist is David Grasmick, who will perform the solo on a piccolo trumpet. Let us give David a rousing round of applause.
Thank you. Wow, what a unique sound that is it not? I've never heard of a piccolo trumpet before tonight, but wow, we're going to invite him back. Wonderful stuff. Well, it's great to have you here tonight. We have a wonderful crowd for an excellent theme. Don't you like the idea of Bond, James Bond? It's a way of recapturing those moments that we spend in the movies, watching those and enjoying, rooting for Bond, having a great time when he got rid of the anti-hero in there. And his ladies of the evening were really nice, too. Halle Berry and others. But what I would like to mention is we've got six of them here. You know, Roger Moore, we've got Pierce Brosnan, Sean Connery. When the evening is over, if you would like to go up and have your picture taken in front of them, feel free to do so. You know, they are available to take home. Not bad. All you have to do is visit the Hungry Tuba and let the Hungry Tuba know how much you like these characters. Pierce Brosnan, I know, is going to get a lot of action. Right, ladies? But we're great. We're really excited to have you here. If I may, I want to give some acknowledgments to those people who play such an important role for each and every one of our concerts. We have a show band production team who is a hard-working group. We have Miriam Keith, Gary Keith, Pat Arnold, Crystal Leonard. They all play an important role. Band manager Bob Mattis, the assistant band manager Steve Collins, and the entire equipment crew, without whose assistance this performance would not be happening. They had nothing to do with our leading characters who were here, but they came on their own. As well, I'd like to thank Tim Greenwood and the Magnolia Video Productions, the City of Ontario, the Inland Valley Daily Bulletin, and the Chaffey Adult School, especially our principal, Todd Haig. You know, and if I look at the guys in their tuxedos, the tallest and the most handsome is Todd Haig. Not bad for a Dakota guy, right? North Dakota, I believe it was. North Dakota. How many people do you know from North Dakota? Especially that live in California. Probably quite a few, I don't know. We'd also like to thank Homero Chavez and the show band, who is a show band stage manager, the audio technician, and also his assistant, Nick Casillas. Homero's group is called Una Noche, and they'll be performing at the Bluefin Patio in Claremont. I don't know where it is, but I'm sure you can find it, and if you're into jazz, you'll love this show. They're going to be there Sunday, May the 7th, from 2 o'clock until 5 p.m., so stop by for a good afternoon of jazz. The Woodwind Celebration, we want to thank for their playing to lead us into tonight's concert. They were out in the foyer. Lithographer Scott Noble, thank you for designing a wonderful program as always. We'd also like to thank our hospitality team of Ruby Levin, Robin DeNegri, and John Hart, all of whom play an important role. If you want to be part of the hospitality team, there's an opportunity for you as well. Just let us know. We sincerely thank the generous show sponsors who are on the back of the program. That's why we list them, because we are so thankful for what they do in the way of contribution for us. You too can support the show band by taking an information card or an envelope at the information table, or by simply visiting the Hungry Tuba, who does not sound like the piccolo trumpet, but it's a different sound, but a good. Also, I'd like to introduce the VIPs who are here this evening. We have the city treasurer for the City of Ontario, Mr. Jim Millhiser. We know how to pick board members, don't we? He's also a board member of ours. Sue Ovitt, the board member for Chaffey Joint Union High School District. She's better looking than Halle Berry. G. Michael Millhiser, a board member from Monta Vista Water District. Dr. Matt Holton, the superintendent for Chaffey Joint Union High School District. I was told I could take a little extra time. Do you know that Chaffey is over 100 years old, the district? and we've only had 9 superintendents. What stability that is. And though I'm biased because my uncle was Alan G. Smith, we've got a great one right now, Dr. Matt Holton. Please do. He deserves it. Also, I'd like to introduce Dr. Kern Oduro, the assistant superintendent for Chaffey Joint Union High School District, in the back, waving. He's there to make sure you get some hot coffee. We also have Al Bowling, who is our vice president for our board, and also the retired Ontario city manager. We have Gary Keith, Life Bible Fellowship pastor and a retired pastor who pastors the pastors. He's also on our board. He's our secretary. He's the best secretary we've had, I'll tell you. He's really good. And finally, I'd like to introduce Richard Ortiz, who is a former Chaffey teacher who is one of our donors as well and comes all the time and usually brings his Chino Hills folks, so we really appreciate that. Thank you, Richard. Well, at this time, we would like to recognize someone who's played an important role. You know, we, as you know, we're the Ontario Chaffey Community Show Band, and we have donors who are, I mean, they both are donors, of course, large donors, to make our program happen. But in addition, we have so much labor that goes into this, and people who need to be involved and play an integral role in everything that we do. And that person is actually going to be retiring after 30 years with the district. And that is the, and he's being summoned to come on down. Come on down, James Bond. Yeah, and so we'll let the superintendent say something if he wouldn't mind.
Yeah, absolutely. So most of you probably don't know this, but Todd Haig hired me back in 1996, 7 or something like that. So I haven't proofread this, but I've been asked to read it. The Friends of the Ontario Chaffey Community Show Band present to Todd Haig, Principal Chaffey Adult School, this plaque of recognition for his continuous support of the Ontario Chaffey Community Show Band and their mission to provide quality musical performances at no cost to the citizens of the greater Ontario community. Todd Haig is one of the finest administrators that has ever worked in the district, and we're going to miss him, but we have a few more, well, about another month or so with you. So give it up for Todd Haig.
Thank you, Todd. We really do appreciate everything you do to help make this program what it is. I think this is a great program. The Ontario Chaffey Community Show Band, no place to be on a Monday night in each month than at the Ontario Chaffey Community Show Band's concert, correct? Thank you again for coming, and please don't forget about the Hungry Tuba. You know why we didn't do the piccolo trumpet? You couldn't put any money in it, so.
I'd like to just take a minute to thank Gary and Matt and Gabe, certainly, and all the members of the show band. That was a very nice gesture. This is my 37th year in the district. Started in 1986, and my wife and I, Debbie, started at the same time at Montclair High School back in 1986. It's been a pleasure, and if you didn't know this already, the Chaffey District and all the schools and the communities it serves is the best in California. I say that not because I've been with the district all these years. I say that because it's a fact, and I say it because I hear it from colleagues throughout the state as I am involved with adult education, and that's the belief throughout the state. So I hope you know that. I hope you appreciate that, because education is a challenge nowadays. Lots of things going on, lots of issues facing our young people, and I really appreciate my time in the Chaffey District. Thank you, Gabe.
Moviegoers find James Bond in Nevada with the 1971 film entitled Diamonds Are Forever. Spectre master villain Ernst Blofeld is back and has hijacked the business empire of a reclusive billionaire as a front to cover his plot. He intends to use high-quality diamonds to create a laser satellite device that can destroy any target on Earth. Bond comes to the rescue, and with the help of the U.S. Marines, destroys Blofeld's satellite system. Please welcome back Kathy Soderlund as she dances to Diamonds Are Forever.
Roger Moore's first film as James Bond came in 1973. he brought a more lighthearted and mature approach to the role that was to last for over a decade. The setting for Live and Let Die takes place in Louisiana and Harlem and on a fictitious Caribbean island. The plot deals with distribution of free heroin throughout the United States to destroy the competition and profit from the ensuing monopoly. The villain, Mr. Big, is dispatched by Bond by throwing him into a shark-infested pool. The theme song for the film was composed by Paul and Linda McCartney. Please welcome assistant director Pat Arnold to the podium as he conducts the show band in Live and Let Die.
The Spy Who Loved Me was released in 1977. The villain in this movie is Carl Stromberg, an anarchist shipping tycoon and scientist who wants to destroy civilization and start again in an underwater city. He intends to start World War III by destroying New York City and Moscow. Teaming up with Bond on behalf of the Soviet Union is Agent Major Amasova. They work together to foil the plot and are successful in defeating Stromberg. Marvin Hamlisch and Carol Bayer Sayer wrote the theme song for this film. Please join me in welcoming to center stage Natasha Lee as she sings Nobody Does It Better.
Another Bond movie takes place in Greece in the year 1981. Most of the action is centered on a mountaintop monastery. The plot involves stealing and selling of an electronic tracking device that can control submarine launching systems. The villain is a Greek shipping magnate, Aristotle Christassos, who also operates as a ruthless drug smuggler. He intends to steal the tracking device and sell it to the Russians. The plot is foiled when Bond and his allies attack the monastery, retrieve the tracking device, and defeat Christassos. The title song from this movie was composed by Bill Conti, who also composed the theme song for the Rocky movie franchise. Please welcome Professor David Grasmick to the podium as he conducts For Your Eyes Only.
A View to a Kill was released in 1985. The storyline involves Stacy Sutton, a geologist for the California Department of Oil and Mines, and her antagonist, Max Zorin, a former KGB agent who now owns a major microchip company. Zorin plots to detonate a bomb under the San Andreas Fault, causing an earthquake to flood San Francisco and Silicon Valley. His plan would kill millions and allow him to dominate the world microchip industry. Mayday, who was betrayed by Zorin, joins with Bond and Sutton to foil Zorin's plan. Zorin is eventually killed by Bond while piloting a blimp over San Francisco. The film's theme song will feature solo alto saxophonist Francisco Mowat. Give him a nice round of applause as he performs A View to a Kill.
Thank you.
The final Bond movie released during the 80s featured Timothy Dalton. In License to Kill, Franz Sanchez, a Mexican drug lord, sends Bond on a mission of vengeance. Sanchez is responsible for the death of his longtime CIA friend and his wife. Sanchez smuggles cocaine in oil, pumping the drug into the United States through a legitimate pipeline. Bond infiltrates Sanchez's inner circle and burns down the villain's drug lab and convoy of oil tankers. The outstanding musicians of the show band are now featuring the film's title song, License to Kill.
Thank you.
Our next Bond film was produced in 1999 with Pierce Brosnan in the starring role. The two villains of the story are ex-KGB agent Victor Zsokas, or his by name Renard, and Elektra King. She, in fact, is the film's real villain. The ring of espionage takes place in the Bay of the Bosphorus. The villain's intention is to blow up Istanbul by overloading the reactor of an atomic submarine. The explosion would render the city and surrounding area with a high level of radiation. This would hand King and her new pipeline a monopoly as the source of oil in the region. Bond and his partner, Dr. Christmas Jones, board the submarine and ultimately impale Renard with a rod of plutonium. King then meets her end on a nearby islet at the hand of our hero. Sit back and enjoy the film's theme song entitled, "The World Is Not Enough."
Thank you.
In 2005, Daniel Craig was cast as James Bond in the remake of Casino Royale. Craig plays opposite Eva Green, whose character is Vesper Lind, a British Treasury agent. The story is set in Montenegro. La Chifra, the chief's film villain, is a private banker for the international terrorist who is forced to organize a high-stakes poker game in Montenegro's Casino Royale to cover a client's funds after a failed investment. Bond is a player in the poker game. After overcoming a near-fatal death by poisoning, he wins the poker tournament, forcing La Chifra into a corner. Ultimately, La Chifra is assassinated by Mr. White, a member of the terrorist organization, for not paying back his debt. Mr. White then contacts Vesper Lind to arrange a deal whereupon she delivers the prize money in exchange for Bond's life. During the transaction in Venice, Bond interrupts the deal, which leads to Lind's drowning. Later, he tracks down Mr. White and eliminates him. The film's theme song features tenor saxophonist and assistant director Pat Arnold in an exciting arrangement of You Know My Name. Join me in giving Pat a nice round of applause.
Thank you.
It is now my pleasure to introduce show band director, Dr. Gabe Petrocelli.
Thank you, Todd. Great heartfelt thanks to the greatest show band in the land, the musicians of the Ontario Chaffey Community Show Band. Here they are. Thank you. Many thanks to President Gary Ovitt and his esteemed board of Friends of the Show Band for their unwavering support. Thank you, Gary, and all the board members that are here. Without their support, we can't do this show. Sue, thank you for your assistance, Sue Ovitt. Also, our distinguished narrators, James Bond and Debbie Haig. Thank you, Todd. Thank you for everything. And the Haig family for sponsoring our performance this evening. I hope you liked it. Assistant Director David Schaffsma, for his work in the multimedia area. He designs all of the our multimedia, the flyers and the programs. He does a great job for us. Thank you, David. And then our talented conductors, we have David Grasmick. Stand up, David. Assistant Director Pat Arnold. And David Schaffsma. Stand up, David. And then our outstanding soloists. We have Daniel Craig over there. Would you give Daniel a nice big round of... Gotcha. Kathy Soderlund, where are you, Kathy? Natasha Lee, great job, Natasha. Stand up, Natasha. And playing the piccolo trumpet, David Grasmick. David. And our fantastic alto player, Francisco Mowat. And our fantastic tenor saxophone player and assistant director, Pat Arnold. We'll be repeating some of these tunes. If you have any time on Saturday, the show band will be performing a one-hour concert at Grace Yokley Middle School in South Ontario from 11 to 12. It's this Saturday, April 29th. Come and enjoy the music and also the car show that, where is she? Karen Greenwood. She is supervising the entire event. She also does a great job with the music program. Some of those members have been members of the show band. Thank you, Karen. And I want to finally thank Susan, my wife. Susan, thank you for the James Bond songbook, without which I couldn't have written this concert. Thank you, Susan. And finally, I want to thank you all for coming tonight. Thank you.
You know, the concert's almost over and you haven't said it yet.
What are you talking about?
You know, what we discussed.
What we discussed? Huh?
Yeah, you know, at the end of, what the Bond's beautiful love interest says at the end of each movie.
Oh, James.
That wasn't so difficult, was it?
The show band closes tonight's performance with the theme song from the 2012 production of Skyfall. The villain in this story is Raul Silva, a former MI6 operative turned cyber terrorist. Able to control internet and computer systems around the world, he operates a secret base at a remote island off Macau. He plans to kill M, the head of MI6, because she betrayed him when working for the department. Bond helps to prevent an initial attempt on M's life. He then takes M to his family estate, Skyfall, in the remote highlands of Scotland. Silva finds them and attacks the estate. After a fierce battle, Bond defeats Silva. However, M dies from a wound, and Bond kills Silva in the final scene of the movie. Join me with a round of applause for the talented musicians of the show band as they perform Skyfall.
I was reminded the next concert, not this Saturday, but the following concert on May 15th will be at the Ontario Town Square, which is on the corner of Euclid and, I don't know, some of those streets. What is it, Gary? Music and C. Yeah, so we'll be there at the band shell. That'll be a great, the only thing you have to do is go in your garage and find your chairs, your lawn chairs, and we'll hope to see you then. Thank you, you're a great audience tonight. Thank you very much.